Hi there, Eagles. This is Miss Autry. I am going to walk you through getting ready and getting prepared for your first week of live sessions. So, starting Monday, August 17th, classes are going live. So, I think that all of our Eagles are ready for this virtual learning journey. You guys have done a great job of navigating through your courses and your course materials and your assignments from last week and ending out the previous week. So, I think that we are ready to go. When you do join on Monday, August 17th, we want to encourage you to wear your East attire and show your Eagle spirit. So on Monday, come wearing those new t-shirts that you may have gotten or an old t-shirt from last year. Okay, so here is our school-wide bell schedule for those synchronous sessions. So remember, synchronous sessions mean that those sessions are live with a teacher. Okay, so these times you will see first period all the way through sixth period. Your day with live sessions ends at 12:45 if you have a sixth period synchronous lesson for that day. So continuing this bell schedule for your courses, so we've got the times down, and here are your courses. So you've got Monday through Friday. You have related arts. So every day you'll have a live session with your related arts teacher. Okay. You'll see Monday, you've got ELA, PLT, and math. Tuesday, PLT, social studies, and math. Wednesday, ELA, social studies, and science, and so forth for Thursday and Friday. So these four sessions, you notice we have six periods in the day. So two periods of the day, you won't have a live session. So that is the time where you can work on your asynchronous lessons or work that your teachers have assigned for you to do on your own time. Okay. And again, this is just a sample. Your student grouping determines what time that you're going to meet for your classes. And I'm going to show you in just a minute how you can be prepared for that and know where to find that. So here's some tips for being successful in these live sessions. So we want everybody to try to show up a few minutes before class time if you can. Find a quiet place free of distractions. Be respectful at all times. We want everybody to stay on mute. That will help with echoing and hearing different background noise. So please stay on mute during your live sessions. If you do have a question or something to share, you can click that raise hand button that is on your Teams photo there when you get into Teams. We want everybody to stay focused, stay as focused as possible and on task so you don't miss anything that the speaker is saying or that your teacher is saying. Okay. We also want you guys to make sure that if you do post into the chat box, do raise your hand and have something to say that you are thinking. You think before you post anything on social media. You think before you text. Think before you type into that chat box that it's true, helpful, inspiring, necessary, and kind. Okay, and you're going to see this acronym being used a lot here, okay, with this virtual learning. So we want to make sure that everybody is thinking. Okay, so where do you guys find these live sessions, the link that's going to take you to your live sessions? So your teachers have posted and will have those links posted for you come Monday morning. If you have a class starting at 8:30, then you'll log into that course. And you will find that link in there. If you're having trouble finding it, if it's not on your updates page or posted right there, or maybe even emailed to you, you can go to your materials tab and you will find a folder that says live sessions link. And you'll have a link in there that you'll click and it will take you directly to that meeting, that live sessions meeting. For those of you that have downloaded the Teams app, your Your teams, your live session teams will stay open in your chat box. So the session may be ended and you may not be able to type and chat in there, but come the next day, you can just find your course if you have the app and you can click join and you don't have to go to that link. But know that that link will always be there as well for you to join the class that way. Okay, so I'm going to exit out of this PowerPoint and I'm just going to show you. We're going to practice a little bit with what this is going to look like for you guys. Okay, so in your Schoology site, okay, you've got your, give it a second here, your courses. And within your courses, I'm going to use my made up sandbox course here. So in your courses, you are going to, let me view this, what you guys see, because it looks different. So I'm going to view this as a student real quick. And within this course, you can then find that folder. I've got a lot of stuff in here. You can find that folder that says live sessions link, and you can click directly on that link, and it's going to open up that Teams, the link for you to be able to join that meeting, okay? Let me go back and show you if you are having a hard time understanding your schedule. Know that all of your courses have the time and the day that you are meeting for your synchronous lesson. So if you are in this particular fifth grade language arts class, in the course title, you will see the time and the days of the week that you will have your live session. Okay, so be on the lookout for that if you're not exactly sure. There is one other place that you can go to find your schedule as well, and it's in this East Enrichment Hub. Okay, let's get this joined up here, and you're gonna go to the Resources tab on the left-hand side, and right there we've got Student Schedules, okay? And within this, you're going to click on your grade level folder. If you have a question or a discrepancy, if there's something that's not right with your schedule, then you can email Ms. Kesey or myself, and we'll be able to help you and navigate you through. Okay, but you can click on the student schedules, and then you can find your grade level in here. So you can go to the sixth grade or fifth grade schedules, and it's going to pop up. And it's going to give everybody a list of their teams, okay, which team they're on. And then it's going to tell them team one, what day. So this is team one schedule. So if you are in team one, you find your name, and then you'll be able to locate your schedule that way, okay? If you are in seventh grade, you can do the same thing. You can click on seventh grade and click through the groups to find your name. Give it a second here. Find your name. Okay, if your name's not on this, then you may need to go back and find another document. And you can see your schedule, your live schedule. The days that, or the times that don't have anything, remember, those are going to be your asynchronous. So you won't have a live session if it is blank in there. Okay. So hopefully that helps with getting you guys set up for success come Monday. Please know that this is new for our teachers. It's new for our students. It's new for our parents. And just to extend grace to everybody, it's going to be a wonderful day, but know that there may be a chance that something doesn't go 100% the way that it was supposed to go or meant to go. And that's okay. We are extending grace to everybody during this time. And like I said, I know this is going to be just a great week and a great launch to virtual learning. So I wish everybody the best, and we will see you guys next week.